the starting lineups, and we'll start with Purdue.
And let's keep an eye here. Lewis Jackson, the junior point guard, really improved his overall play. Travis Carroll getting his second start career-wise. He's going to be counted on the front line.
And for West Virginia.
And then Daryl Bryant, the other point guard in this game. He could be a lightning rod, folks. And then also John Flowers, we talked about him. He also had 5 assists and 5 steals in his last game out.
Huggy Bear, Bob Huggins in his 4th season. One of America's elite coaches. Coach Huggins coming off his first Big East championship as well as a trip to the Final Four 1 year ago. Bird, Driscoll, Higgins. 6th all-time meeting between these two schools. Last year, Purdue defeated West Virginia in West Lafayette. Boilers travel to Morgantown for the first time since 1975, and Purdue has never lost in the 5 meetings to the Mountaineers. And early on, West Virginia controlling the tip. What should we pay attention to?
Well, let's keep an eye from West Virginia's standpoint. Their ability to create scoring opportunities against this vaunted Purdue pressure. You see, they like to extend and disrupt your offense.
Bryant, pull-up jumper, comes up short. Loose ball, batted around, Mountaineers have it, but step on the line. So the Purdue Boilermakers will bring it up the floor. Purdue 15-2 on the season, 4-1 in conference play. They're coming off a 70-67 loss to Minnesota on Thursday. However, they've won 10 of their last 11.
Yeah, Minnesota is a good team, so that's no really problem in losing to a team like Minnesota on the road.
Etwan Moore, mid-range jump shot, pure. And that's a great sign for this senior guard.
You make a great point. He only made 2 of his 14 field goal attempts last time out against Minnesota. If they get him going, it's a big concern for Bob Huggins in West Virginia.
And let's see if Etwan Moore can get to the free throw line. He hasn't been to the free throw line in his last 3 games. He had 5 points in that loss to Minnesota on Thursday. Now Jones. West Virginia coming off a 93-63 win over Providence. They also defeated, prior to that, Georgetown and DePaul, and the Mountaineers turn it over.
And you've seen the last 2 possessions, West Virginia loses the ball on the baseline. Again, Purdue, one of the best in the country at team defense. They always know, all 5 guys on the floor, where the basketball is.
So Lewis Jackson will walk it up the floor. And Greg, you're really proud of the way he's been playing lately. He's done a nice job scoring the ball.
He has, and you know, he's not noted as a shooter, but you can improve your field goal percentage simply by improving your shot selection. That's something he's done this season. That's what we call experience. And one reason why Purdue has really elevated their play in the absence of Robbie Hummel.
Juwan Johnson pull-up jump shot, ribbed off, and a whistle. Offensive foul coming up, and it will go against the Boilermakers.
You saw there, Juwan Johnson, they're going to go to him both inside and out. Carroll picking up his foul. We talked about it. He's in the lineup in part to deal with the athleticism of West Virginia on that front line.
Al Bryant, New York City point guard. He's got unlimited offensive skills. Still trying to learn how to play the game, especially as a point. Now off the bounce, inside, knocked away, picked up. Jackson on the fast break, Purdue with numbers. Jackson hands it off, and a whistling foul coming up. And Juwan Johnson will go to the line and shoot 2. Nice no-look pass in transition.
It really was. He did a great job of waiting to the last moment. Here, first, take a look at the defense. They do a great job with the help. They get the deflection, and that turns immediately into a transition opportunity. And the delivery of the pass at the last moment allows for the foul to be created by Juwan Johnson.
So Juwan Johnson, one of America's greatest talents at the college level. As you take a look at his numbers, last year against West Virginia, he had 25 and 10 rebounds. And he's a good free throw shooter as well. What's the book on JJ?
Well, he's a smooth operator. His ability to go both inside and out. He likes to spike. We'll use a little volleyball term because he's one of the best shot blockers in America. And then the consistency, that's what really, I think, separates him as a senior. The fact that he has gotten better each and every year. they projected him to be this type of player when they recruited him.
And he's a Johnson.
Yes.
Three to nothing, Purdue with the lead. Boilermakers only two losses this season, Thursday against Minnesota. Prior to that, a loss to Richmond in a non-conference game. Surprising there. And Calicelli throws the ball out of bounds.
And, you know, this is reminiscent last season when they matched up. West Virginia really struggled with their ability to take care of the basketball. And last, these non-conference games, how about that loss to Richmond you talked about, but then the win against Virginia Tech, and then Oakland, a much improved basketball team, almost knocked off Michigan State, and then beat Tennessee when they were ranked seventh in the country.
Great tip in
at Tennessee as well.
Great tip in by Juwan Johnson, and the Boilermakers take a 5-0 lead.
Yeah, and what's most impressive defensively on the road, Purdue's taking the crowd out of it. They have done a great job of not allowing West Virginia to execute offensively.
Jones, come. Kevin Jones averaging 14 a game. He could be averaging close to 20 if his free throw shooting was better. He's a 56% free throw shooter.
Well, that's not his strength. We'd all love for him to shoot it better, especially if you're a Mountaineer fan. But he does so many other things well out on the basketball floor that allow you to win games.
Etwan Moore. Johnson pulls up around the rim, no. Jones clears it. West Virginia 53-2 in non-conference games over the last 8 years. Calicelli across the lane, jump hook, and gets the bomb.
And that's the first opportunity with his back to the basket for Calicelli. Beautiful drive across the lane there. The help defense did not get there in time to prevent the basket.
Game tied at 5. Now, Jackson. Bounce pass inside, and a foul. Quick move to the basket for Johnson, and he will shoot free throws once again.
Well, early struggles early on for West Virginia, but Kevin Jones, your best all-around player, gets you going, and then you also got to be able to attack on the interior. Calicelli with the beautiful sweeping left-handed hook. West Virginia, Purdue, all tied.
Welcome back to Morgantown. Let's take a look at home court advantage presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. West Virginia, 42-9 at home under. Bob Huggins, 21-1 versus non-conference teams. They've won 9 of their last 10 home games, averaging close to 80 points per game, Greg.
Yeah, offensively, they've improved in part because defensively they do such a good job of denying you rhythm opportunities, which leads to transition opportunities.
And Bob Huggins yesterday in practice, you know what I love about Coach Huggins, dating back to his time at Cincinnati, he rides his guys so hard in practice. It's an unorthodox way of coaching, but it's his way. His players respond by his challenges, and one person in particular that he wanted to play well was Calicelli.
Well, he thinks talent-wise, he could be as good as any frontline player in the conference, but sometimes the mental approach that he takes is not at the level from an intensity standpoint that Bob Huggins expects. And so I think you're going to see that work today in terms of their team. And you talk about that tough love that he shows. His guys, they do. They respond to it. That's one reason why he's been so successful, because Bob Huggins is genuine with those that he coaches.
Juwan Johnson making both free throws. 5 points to start this game for Johnson. Of the 7, Mountaineers almost turn it over. Flowers picks it up. Mitchell's been quiet. Watch Casey Mitchell, number 3, yellow. And an offensive foul call. Looks like a moving screen coming up against the Mountaineers.
And you've seen it earlier on. Purdue does such a good job of disrupting your timing and your spacing offensively. They really are out there to force you to try to play one-on-one. They don't want to allow you to execute your offense.
Cam Thurlman comes up with the foul. He's guarding Juwan Johnson now. Etwan Moore, in and out, dribble, picked it up. Smith downtown, off the heel. Rebounded by John Flowers. Flowers is really playing well on the season. He's coming off a career high, 24 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists, 5 blocks, 3 steals against Providence the other night.
That's a season for a lot of young players on the Division I level. What an impressive performance by Mr. Flowers.
Jones posting up, drop step, jump hook, no. DJ Bird with the rebound. Here comes Purdue. Kelsey Barlow playing with the tender ankle. Johnson on the wing, off the dribble, cut off nicely. Moore, 15-footer. And a rebound to Flowers again.
Yeah, but good look offensively for Purdue last two times down, just unable to convert. Conversely, West Virginia's starting to get the ball in on the interior. They're starting to get some post-up opportunities, and that may loosen up the perimeter game for Casey Mitchell.
Nate Mitchell fires a jumper. And Barlow pulls it down. He'll rake it and take it. Inside, Johnson. Stripped out of bounds. Oh, and they say it goes off of Juwan Johnson, and West Virginia gets it back.
And you can take a look here. Good post position now. Unable to convert here, but the most important thing is you're getting those opportunities. You want to force Purdue's defense to start playing from the free throw line and below. Right now, they're able to extend their pressure, which is really disrupting West Virginia's offense. So look for them to try to attack more on the interior against Purdue.
Purdue turns it over for the first time on the season. The Boilermakers only average 11 turnovers. They force 16. Truck Bryant, no. Thurman can't hold on. Out of bounds. And we'll head the other way.
And speaking of turnovers, Gus, last year when these two met, remember we talked about 18 turnovers by West Virginia. A lot of times, a lot of teams aren't accustomed to the type of pressure that Purdue presents. They really extend and get out and contest everything.
Johnson knocked away by Thurman. Great job. Mitchell. Now Jones, top of the key. Flowers with a rebound, and he's fouled.
You get early offense there by West Virginia, and that, a lot of times that early offense, Gus, is where you get a lot of opportunities on the offensive glass because the defensive team is kind of cross-matched. They're not able to get the big bodies on big bodies.
And that sends John Flowers to the line, the senior from Waldorf, Maryland, averaging 9 points a game and 6 rebounds. First free throw good. He's a 74% free throw shooter.
You know, I was talking with the coaching staff before. You know, this is a young man who, as a freshman, this is what they projected him to be in terms of his overall skill set. Not necessarily a great offensive player, but a very good basketball player. He does a little bit of everything to help your team win games.
Typical Bob Huggins yes. type player. He is tall and long.
Yes. He is a space eater.
Now Johnson comes in as a backup point guard. Bird pulls it inside and a foul on the floor. Great pass and nice catch by Juwan Johnson inside. Looks like Thurlman will be called for the foul. And that's his second.
Yeah, and he had not a great angle for the entry pass, but a good delivery. And the most important thing there, Juwan Johnson held his position. And that's what creates the foul by Thurlman there. And you know what? Bob Huggins talked about this yesterday at practice. They respect Juwan Johnson, as you obviously have to. They're going to run bodies at him, different players, give him different looks, and really try to disrupt his flow offensively.
And Bob Huggins telling us we have 30 fouls. We're going to try to use all of them on Juwan Johnson. Now down the lane, baseline, quick release. And that one sails wide. And here comes West Virginia. John Hart off the mark. Truck Bryant. Here come the Boilers. Jackson to the bucket. And one.
And that's exactly, and Lewis Jackson just hurt his ankle on that play. But and let's hope the young man's all right. He is so vital to the success of what Purdue does. I think he turned it after the shot when he came down. Checking in for the Mountaineers. This is great decision making, though. You know, he keeps it. He forces the defense to have to make a decision, and I just hope he didn't stand, or step, I should say, on Bryant's foot. You can't really see it on that replay, but that would be a huge loss if Purdue does not have their junior leader at the point.
Boilermakers banged up. You know Robbie Hummel is out for the year. Now Jackson twisting his ankle. Kelsey Barlow's playing with an injured ankle. There's Robbie Hummel. And with a healthy Robbie Hummel on the floor for Purdue, the Boilermakers would instantly become a legitimate Final Four type team. But he injured his knee at the beginning of the season when they started working out, and he's lost for the year. He'll come back and get a redshirt season.
The foul line for Purdue, number zero, Tyrone Johnson.
So right? Tyrone Johnson will come in and shoot the free throw. Johnson on the season, a 57% free throw shooter. And remember last year, Lewis Jackson missed 19 games with a foot injury. So hopefully he'll be able to walk this one off. 9-7, Boilers. 12-16 to play in the first half. Mitchell, former junior college national player of the year, has it knocked away. Loose ball picked up to the basket. Moore, no, tapped around. Johnson gets the roll.
Goodbye, Johnson.
And I can tell you what, Bob Huggins will not be happy with the lack of transition defensively by West Virginia. Two offensive opportunities on the backboard for Purdue.
Joe Mazzulla checks in for the West Virginia Mountaineers. Left-hander to the bucket, double clutch, no, but a foul. 11:41 to play in the first half. So far, Purdue on the road, out-hustling the Mountaineers on their floor.
With all three of us, so it would have been cool to be able to finish with those guys, but unfortunately, it didn't work out. And it's definitely frustrating for me because I wanted to be out here with these guys. But, you know, looking ahead to next year, I think we're going to have a great team. And that's not to say that we can't do big things this year, but I'm really looking forward to getting back on the court.
Well, right now, Robbie, I want you to play a little bit of coach, since I know you're overanalyzing a little bit, not being able to be out there. What do you think you guys are going to have to do today to have success against Purdue? Against West Virginia, I'm sorry.
We're going to really have to rebound the ball. Kevin Jones is a beast inside, and we're going to have to really contain him. And obviously, we can't let Truck Bryant and Joe Mazzulla and John Flowers get going, because they're all very good players. And especially Casey Mitchell, too. He can really shoot the ball.
All right, Robbie, thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you go through all your rehab and do it all, because we can't wait to see you on the floor next year.
No problem. I appreciate you guys having me on.
You got it.
Thanks, Robbie.
Yep, no problem.
You know what's interesting about Robbie Hummel? You know, you often talk about leadership. And oftentimes, it's easy to lead when things are going well. True leadership comes when there's adversity and when you have to truly show your character. That's what Robbie Hummel displays for this team right now, being there every day, being in the mix, even though he can't physically get out there and participate.
One man showing leadership for his team is Dennis Kalichla. He's hit back-to-back field goals, and he's establishing himself as the presence that Bob Huggins wants him to be inside. Let's see if they go to the big guy again and keep his hands full.
And, you know, one adjustment Coach Huggins has made, he's gone with Mazzulla and Bryant, both point guards, to kind of offset the pressure and to give West Virginia an opportunity to execute offensively. Six turnovers before. Now you see the rhythm. You see them starting to attack on the interior. And Mr. Kalichla is getting it done.
He's 3 for 3, 6 points. And, folks, when I tell you that Bob Huggins rode him in practice yesterday, wow. He really got on the big guy, and he's coming out playing well right now, contesting that Juwan Johnson shot. 1 point game. Mazzulla, the fifth year senior, who's getting his master's degree in athletic coaching, had that great NCAA tournament last year. Jones facing. They're going to Kalichla again. Heat check. Tried to deal it down, and he throws it out of bounds. But in the meantime, he knocks a Purdue player to the floor. He's playing aggressively.
He is being physical out there, and he's seeking contact. Here, the beautiful right shoulder turn for the left hook. And again, we talked about it earlier, Gus. They're trying to establish a low post presence. They want to bring Purdue's defense down below the free throw line, as I said, to try to get some of those opportunities out on the perimeter.
Dennis Kalichla, a sophomore from Istanbul, Turkey. He's also on the Turkish national team. 9:20 to play in the first half. Etwan Moore second active leading scorer in the Big Ten. And he's fouled. Let's take a look at Dennis Caligula.
And again, you notice everything's coming down on that low block. The help defense not getting there, and he's doing a good job of getting inside the paint. And again, everything's been the same. That right shoulder, left hand hook shot. Purdue's going to have to make the adjustment if they want to have a chance to contain him. He's kind of that X factor. We thought it would be John Flowers, but early on here, it's been Caligula.
Caligula right at his season average. Flowers picks up his second foul. So he heads to the bench. Now each one more, curling down the lane, cut off Juwan Johnson, 16-footer. Count it. That's one thing that he has improved on over the 4 years in his career.
Yeah, we talked about that versatility, his ability to step out on the pick and pop and knock down that mid-range jump shot with consistency really presents a challenge for you defensively to contain him.
Bryant, guarded by Jackson, who's back in the game for Purdue. Mazzulla down the lane and gets the roll.
I'll tell you what, since Mazzulla has come into this game, it has really changed the dynamic. West Virginia offensively now getting to the rim.
Mazzulla named the most outstanding player of the 2010 East Regional after having a huge game against Kentucky, 17 points. He's lost weight, put on some muscle. Bryant, three, got it. Now Truck Bryant can move to the off guard, and he feels much more comfortable in that position.
He does. He's more of a scoring lead guard, which is fine from the shooting guard position because you're going to get created opportunities for you as opposed to initiating from the point. And Lewis Jackson still hobbling a little bit, but knocks down that mid-range jump shot.
Ties the game at 17. Lewis Jackson coming off a 15.7 rebound, 5 assist game in 27 minutes against Minnesota. Bryant off the bounce to the bucket, short, cleared inside. Bryant again, and one. Count the basket. And Truck Bryant will go to the line, trying to complete the conventional three-point play. It's getting warm in Morgantown. 1917, Mountaineers at the strike. Back after this. And welcome back to Morgantown, West Virginia. As you take a look at the game summary, Mountaineers doing well now. 7 of 15 shooting. They've hit 2 threes. High, though, for turnovers with 7. Juwan Johnson with 7 points. Gus Johnson along with Greg Anthony. And Greg, this, as you mentioned, is a signature game for West Virginia.
It really is. In terms of selection Sunday, when you look at this team now, they have the advantage of playing in the Big East, the best conference in America, and they've gotten some quality road wins. But this is one of those games that you have to look at, non-conference game against a quality opponent ranked 8th in the country at the time. And not only that, if you win it from a confidence standpoint, what it will do to elevate your team as you progress throughout conference play.
Bob Huggins has led two teams to the Final Four, 1992. It was Cincinnati. Had guys like Nick Van Exel. That's when they played against the Fab Five, and Chris Webber lost in the Final Four. And then last year, making it all the way to the Final Four, winning the Big East Championship. 2017. West Virginia. Etwan Moore curling, in and out dribble, wheeling, fires, way short. Truck Bryant the other way. Now Caligula posting. He's perfect. Drop step, pivot. And he throws it out of bounds. You can build your own basketball dynasty and compete year-round with CBSSports.com Franchise Basketball on Facebook. Find out more at CBSSports.com/franchise. And Greg, you were saying, now you were in Pittsburgh yesterday, this game is like the Steelers and the Ravens.
It's
not pretty.
No, but these are the two mirror images of one another. They both really, they win the same way. They are going to disrupt and try to dominate you defensively and create and generate offense off of that.
to the basket. Smith, who's been playing some excellent basketball lately, and an offensive foul. Each one more trying to back his man down. And Mazzulla flops and takes a charge.
Senior on senior, this is experience here. He took the first hit, so that gets the attention of the official. And then when Moore delivers the second one, you saw him, a little bit of acting skill there, able to pick up that personal foul against Etwan Moore.
So Etwan Moore remains in the game after picking up his first. Bryant. Jones, Kalitzla, nice position, and he traveled. Too much for Dennis Kalitzla, and Bob Huggins looks at him. But getting back to Etwan Moore.
And, you know, as great a player as he is, take a look at that, folks. No free throws in the last three games. That's really unheard of for one of the elite players in college basketball. He's got to become more aggressive. He shot the three so well early on this season that he's kind of fallen in love with it and got away from getting into attack mode.
Jawan Johnson with the jump hook. So the last time he came down, he hit a baseline 17-foot jumper. Now he goes in the pivot and hits a beautiful sky hook.
Smooth operator. What we talked about on the blog, his ability to score inside and out really creates matchup problems for you.
Mazzulla short. Johnson with 9 points. Here comes Etwan Moore in transition. The lob. Johnson saves it from going out of bounds. Barlow, the kick. Etwan off the heel. And Kalitzla comes up with the defensive rebound. Truck Bryant. Crosstown traffic now. High pick and roll. Mazzulla. Extra dribble. Blocked by Moore. Here comes Purdue with numbers. They have Barlow on the wing. Nice bounce pass. Oh, and he missed a bunny rabbit. Out of bounds.
Oh, you got a feel for him. Ball slipped out of his hands. Got a little complacent with that. Thought it was going to be an easy one. You got to go up aggressive, young fella, and finish that. You can't ever take anything for granted, especially on the road.
5:14 to play. 20-19, West Virginia. Mountaineers on the season, 11-4, 3-2 in Big East play. So we've got the Big East versus the Big Ten, two of the top conferences in America. Jones posting to the bucket. Out of bounds, and we'll stay right here.
Again, we talked about it earlier, the one adjustment, too, really, that Huggins made to get them back in the game. One, bringing Mazzulla into the game to kind of settle them offensively, and then trying to attack on the interior. And Matt Painter's got to be happy with his team's effort and intensity defensively. They've been disruptive. They've been able to create opportunities in transition, just have not been able to convert as consistently as he would like.
All right, Dalton Pepper comes in the game, a sophomore. From Levittown, Pennsylvania, for West Virginia. He's averaging 4 points a game, playing 12 minutes a game on the season. Inside, Mitchell, scoreless thus far, picked up by Johnson. He'll push it hard into the front court, straight to the bucket. They don't pick him up, and he can't bank it in. Kalitzla with another rebound. And Bryant throws it out of bounds. See why Hawaii 5-0 is the People's Choice Award winner. For favorite new TV drama, catch an all-new episode tomorrow. Only CBS. 11 turnovers for West Virginia in the first half, and they average on the season 12 per game.
And how about they're still leading? So, you know, you got to give them some credit for what they've done defensively, but offensively, 11 turnovers, that is far too many. And some of them have been unforced. Now, the defense from Purdue has been good, but I don't think it's been so good that you should have 11 turnovers.
Barlow, hesitation. This time he'll lay it in with the pretty right-hand finger roll.
Yeah, he's long and athletic, and he's got enough quickness to be able to get by you on the perimeter.
Sophomore from Indy. He scored in double figures over his last three. Kalitzla. And a whistle and foul.
And how about the job defensively Purdue has done on Casey Mitchell here early in this game? He's the leading scorer for West Virginia. Zero field goal attempts, and has not been able to get going. Again, credit Purdue defensively. one of the focuses had to be to take something away from West Virginia. Casey Mitchell has been that thus far.
So let's take a look. We told you we had stars on the floor. And so far,
only one shining.
Johnson is the leader. Exactly.
Only one is shining. And Casey Mitchell did get one field goal attempt. I thought he got one up earlier. But unfortunately for West Virginia, they haven't been able to get him going, but they have gotten Kalichla involved offensively, and that's made a difference in terms of them being in this game.
As he misses the front end of the 1-1, Purdue up by a penny, under four to go. They reverse it, Johnson. And Barlow. That's an offensive foul, swinging his elbows. One of the points of emphasis in college basketball this year. One-point game. Back after this. And welcome back. Let's take a look at the AT&T in-game analysis update.
Yeah, more not getting it going here offensively early on for Purdue. But they've done the job. They've been able to contain West Virginia somewhat in terms of the offensive rebounding. And Ryan Smith, John Flowers. Flowers has impacted 6 rebounds.
Now this is Kelsey Barlow swinging his elbow.
Yeah, that's that new point of emphasis for the NCAA on that play. And again, it doesn't have to be intentional, but if someone's up on you like that, you're not allowed to swing that elbow above the shoulders, which is what happened on that play.
Now coming up on AT&T at the half, join Jumpin' James Brown. Do you know when James Brown was at DeMatha High School, he could literally jump to the top of the backboard, just like Earl the Goat Manigo, and snatch quarters off the top of the backboard. And he'll be with Seth Davis for all the scores and highlights, plus the latest college basketball news. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. And when James Brown was in high school, Lefty Driesell took out a full-page ad in the Washington Post to try to get him to go to Maryland.
Yeah, JB was a great player, but I think he made the right choice.
His mother made the right choice. Well, she said, baby, you're going to Harvard, and there is no question about it.
I tell you what, I think he made the right one. I think it's worked out pretty well for JB.
Pretty well for JB. Azula at the line, shooting the 2 free throws after the intentional foul. And Azula gets him to go. Purdue make that West Virginia now with a 22-21 lead. How great of a coach is Matt Painter?
Well, you know, the fact that his team has responded so well with all the injuries. You talked about Lewis Jackson missing 19 games last year. Hummel out towards the end of last season, and obviously out all season here as well.
Jones slid his pivot foot. He was pushed. And he'll go to the line and shoot 2, but the Mountaineers have been really sloppy with the ball.
Yeah, we made the point, 18 against Purdue last year. And again, a lot of these have been unforced. That was good defense, but they have not done a good job of moving the basketball, too much dribbling or over-dribbling into traffic, creating bad passing angles for their team. I got a feeling Bob Huggins is going to have a word or two with his team in terms of their spacing and their lack of playing for one another. Maybe a little bit too much self-willing it out there on the floor.
Now, Coach Huggins has that look on his face all the time, but his players just really love him. I mean, every one of his players, dating back to his time in Cincinnati and before, always call him after big games that they watch on national TV. Danny Fortson, Nick Van Exel, Kenyon Martin. They swear by him, justifiably so. Johnson inside, picks up his dribble in the paint. Jackson, fadeaway, airball. Here comes Mazzulla. Kalichla wants it inside. He's got about 40 pounds on Juwan Johnson. And another foul.
And that's an example. They are not going to allow you to create that space. And what's interesting, that's an example of the play. Remember we talked about when you swing it above the shoulders, there, that's just a push-off. Well, you're not allowed to create space like that, though, and especially when you do it right in front of the official. I mean, you could have, you know, an understanding where you wouldn't like that call made against you, but there's no doubt that he created space 35 feet away from the basket.
I understand the rule, but is that a little too much, Greg?
No, I actually don't have a problem with the call. Good play there by Etuan Moore. Maybe that'll get him going in the interior. Only because a defensive player is allowed to have position. Now, once he's established that position, you're not allowed to then dislodge him. And that's, in essence, what happened on that play.
Michael Jordan used to do that to you all the time when you were playing with the Knicks.
That's a different level. This is on the collegiate level.
Inside Kalitra. Almost threw it away. 10 to shoot. Knocked away, stolen by Johnson. Another turnover for the Mountaineers. They're going to get Bryant back in the game. 13 turnovers. JJ, count it.
Transition. I mean, what a luxury to have a player like Juwan Johnson. You can feature him on the block. You can put him in the pick and roll. He can also finish in transition as that trailer, where oftentimes you're going to catch it at that three-point line uncontested.
He has 12 points. Now guarding Kalichla. Purdue making it really hard for West Virginia to run their stuff. 10 to shoot. Missoula, step back jump shot. Kalichla, offensive rebound. Mitchell tracks it down. He'll fire. And that's who they're missing. Casey Mitchell, scoreless in this game. He's 0 for 2. And he's averaging close to 18. Missoula with the steal. Jones, the trailer, leads it for him. And a foul.
Now, Juwan Johnson, take a look at this, how the defense all below the free throw line. And that's going to create the opportunity right here for Juwan Johnson to step right into that three-pointer. The defense doesn't react. You're always taught to guard the rim first in transition. But, folks, the game of college basketball has evolved. You now have to be concerned with the three-point shot in transition. But what makes it tougher for teams like West Virginia against Purdue, Juwan Johnson's your center, your power forward, who's able to come down and knock down that three-pointer.
McJones gets the first one to go. What's the book?
Well, he's a slasher. He's one of those guys that can just create opportunities off the bounce on that baseline. He defends all five positions, and really, he's a jack of all trades. He does a little bit of everything to help your team play winning basketball.
And for Kevin Jones, junior from Mount Vernon, New York, some great players have come out of Mount Vernon. The Williams brothers, Gus Williams, Ray Williams. Denzel Washington, by the way, is from Mount Vernon. And for Kevin Jones, his free throw shooting is 25 of 45 coming into this game, 56%. If he can improve on that, the sky is the limit. Jackson, step back, 14-footer, no good. Here comes Truck. He's got Mitchell on the wing, feeds him, drives, hands it off inside.
You know what? That's one of the first plays you saw West Virginia play for one another in this basketball game. They do a great job of creating the opportunity for their teammates. They're up by one, and this place is rocking.
Tomorrow, Dave's All New with Jack Hanna's Animals, Steve Tyler, and Tuesday, Betty White plus Kim and Courtney Kardashian, followed by Craig Ferguson, only CBS. Mount Vernon, some of the great players that have come out of Mount Vernon High.
I tell you what, it doesn't get any better. Lowe's Moore, remember him? He's a West Virginia alum. Scored 40 in a game here for him. And how about Ben Gordon still getting it done in the national championship? Rodney McRae won one. His brother Scooter was also probably more heralded coming out of high school than even Rodney was. And then you mentioned Gus and Ray Williams, one of the best brother guard tandems to ever play the game of basketball.
And Kevin Jones trying to follow in that long line of terrific players out of Mount Vernon, New York. Last year, he really took a huge step forward, developed his outside shot. He was an NCAA East Regional All-Tournament selection, also on the Big East All-Tournament team. 27-26, 30 seconds of play. Jackson, the kick. Carroll got it.
That's an interesting set that Purdue ran at. They basically run a pick and roll with two guards that stand parallel to one another, and then they give Jackson the option to go either way.
28-27, Purdue with the lead, 17 and a half remaining in the first.
To make the adjustments defensively. I don't know that they win, but I do think it's going to be a very competitive football game.
This has been a very competitive first half, one-point game. They spread it for Bryant. 8 seconds. He'll go down the lane, pull up jump shot. Got it. Drop Bryant off the dribble from half court. And that is the end of the first half. Despite turning it over, 7 lead changes, 4 ties. West Virginia up by a point. Now let's go to James Brown in New York.
Thanks, guys. Coming up on AT&T at the half, scores and highlights, plus Seth Davis has his news and notes. That'll be coming your way after this message and a word from your local station.
Mountaineers with the lead over number 8 Purdue at halftime. Let's take a look at the Powerade complete breakdown of the first half.
Yeah, turnovers was a key for Purdue to keep them in it, but then the offensive rebounding, 7 of those for West Virginia, they rebounded half of their misses. That allowed them to stay in the game as well.
All right, Gus Johnson along with Greg Anthony. And Greg, what a competitive first half for both these teams.
Yeah, they're really mirror images of one another defensively, very intense and disruptive, not allowing you to have any flow to your offense. And then the two big guys that we talked about, the stars, really, Juwan Johnson and then also Kevin Jones. Neither guy came out of the game in the first half. Both played the 20 minutes. And then Kevin Jones, you know, a little bit of everything, finishing on the outside, also on the interior. Juwan Johnson, 12 points, 3 rebounds, couple assists, and a block shot in that first half. They really rode him, did Purdue. And that's one reason why they're in the game. It's going to be interesting to see if they can get some help from Equan Moore. And then also Dennis Kalichla really was a nice impact for West Virginia on the interior.
Equan Moore in that first half, 4 points. And here's the big player for West Virginia that really hadn't had a chance to get going. Casey Mitchell scoreless in the first half as Juwan Johnson comes in and immediately hits a jump hook to give Purdue a 30-29 lead. Casey Mitchell averaging close to 18 a game, 0-for-2 in the first half, no points. Let's see if they look to get him going early on here in the second. They need his offense, as Bob Huggins told us. The most important thing for them to do is hit shots today. They need scores.
Yeah, they do, but I think one of the problems has been their inability to really run their offense and really execute. It's kind of taken them out of their rhythm, and credit Purdue for doing a job defensively.
And there's Mitchell.
And that's an example, Gus, right there. Great baseline execution on the out of bounds. Nice little curl screen and the delivery of the pass on the money here. And then catch it and flowing in rhythm with the contact.
So Casey going to the line. Second year at West Virginia in 2009. He was the National Junior College Player of the Year. As he adds a free throw, he's from Savannah, Georgia. Ran into his mom in the elevator today at the hotel. What a wonderful lady who's so proud of her son.
And as she should be. He's really matured and quite the leader for West Virginia this season.
Equan Moore inside, almost threw it away. They swing it. Barlow explodes on the baseline. The kick, Moore, short. Mitchell, sweeping rebound. Now Truck Bryant. He'll pull up, stop and start to the basket. The kick, Mitchell, pumps. Kalichla, left hand again, halfway down, pops out. Jones with the rebound. And the Mountaineers get a new shot clock. Kalichla again inside. Jump hook again. Batted around. John Flowers banks it in.
And the offensive backboard, that's the third already to start this second half for West Virginia.
Mountaineers go up by 4. Barlow, 15-footer off the dribble, rattles home.
Nice play. Dribble penetration, mid-range pull-up, quiets the crowd for Purdue.
Marlow with 6 points. On the season, he averages six. Kalinchla handing it off to Bryant. Jones a three. And the smallest man on the floor, Lewis Jackson, with the rebound. 3-on-2 to the bucket. The runner got it for Lewis Jackson. And he goes just as far as that defense allows him.
He really does, and that's what you want to do. Put the pressure on the defense. Force them to react. They did not stop his penetration. Therefore, he's able to get all the way to the rim.
And you used to play with a guy named LJ as well years ago. Inside, Bryant, no. Carroll hauls it down. Here's Jackson. Crosses over. Juwan Johnson again. So smooth, so versatile. A quiet 16 points.
It seems to be quiet every time he plays because, you know, there's not a lot of banter, no antics from Juwan Johnson. He just goes out and competes.
Johnson with 29 points on Thursday against Minnesota. He also had 11 rebounds. Down the lane, up and in. Travis Carroll, and what a great pace to start this second half. They're going up and down now.
Yeah, you gotta like Purdue. Every time they've gotten a rebound or a turnover, they pushed it in transition, not allowing West Virginia to get their defense set. And then you take a look, Purdue in transition. Jackson gets the rebound, and then you take a look, he puts pressure. Defense never commits to him, therefore he's able to get to the rim, and then part of that 8-0 run, Juwan Johnson knocking down that mid-range jump shot there. And then here, I love the transition find by Etwan Moore for the finish. Purdue on that 8-0 run.
Coach K trying to figure out how to adjust his team.
Yeah, Nolan Smith coming off a huge game the other night, 29 points, and the win over Virginia. They'll be fine. Obviously, though, you don't just replace a guy like Kyrie Irving, arguably the best freshman in the country.
Johnny West is checked in for West Virginia. He's a shooter, the son of the legendary Jerry West. Mazzulla down the lane, and goes. Mazzulla so strong with that left hand.
He is, and I tell you what, he's done a really good job with the penetration and attacking Purdue's pressure.
38-36, Boilers. Etwan Moore. They lob it, Juwan Johnson, he's been brilliant. Turnaround jumper. And a foul coming up. It will go against Travis Carroll. Tonight on 60 Minutes, the voice of the alleged Tucson shooter recorded just hours before the massacre. And a look inside the mind of an assassin tonight on 60 Minutes, only CBS. 15-28 to play, second half, 2-point game in Morgantown. And you wonder why Bob Huggins' players love him so much. One of the greatest moments in the history of college basketball to me took place in last year's national semifinal versus Duke. West Virginia, their hopes were crushed when their star, Deshaun Butler, went down with a knee injury. And in one of the most poignant moments of the NCAA tournament, Bob Huggins consoled his senior captain. And earlier today, for the first time since his second surgery, Deshaun Butler took the court and warmed up. And he is in attendance today. Right there, Deshaun Butler says he will get that knee going. He will be 100% again. But right now, he is getting the opportunity to rehab and right here in Morgantown. And I tell you what, every time when I saw that last year, tears were in my eyes, especially when you saw how Coach Huggins consoled his guy.
And Gus, many times your head coach in college is a surrogate father for you. So many of these young men don't have a relationship or a father. I was one of those kids. I never met my father, so the coach was instrumental in my development, not just as a player, but as a person.
Inside, turnover, Flowers going to the basket. Your coach, Jerry Tarkanian. One of the legends of college basketball. How's Coach Tark doing?
His health is not as good as we would like, but he's a fighter, and he's still hanging in there. much like these two teams right now, fighting it out here, tie game, intense environment. It's what you expect from two of the elite programs in college basketball.
Game tied at 38, maybe a resume game for West Virginia when the committee gets together and start to think about who should get in the tournament and who shouldn't.
And you're seeing also what Huggins talked about, Coach Huggins. He's rotating those bodies on Juwan Johnson, trying to give him a different look defensively.
Etwan Moore, got it. Nice open look for Moore. And he knocks it down, 41-38. Now Mazzulla, Flowers, across the lane, has that been blocked by Moore. Picked up, Barlow. Finds Moore again. Points in bunches for Etwan Moore.
They're getting more from Etwan here in this second half. He's come out on fire and really a nice compliment to Juwan Johnson.
10 points for Etwan Moore. He had 4 in the first half. Largest lead of the game for Purdue. Dangerous area for West Virginia. Mazzulla. Flowers wants it again. Kalichla inside. Turnaround lefty again off the glass. Rims off. Here comes Etwan Moore. Johnson driving this time. And foul. And it will be out of bounds.
Yeah, he is such a tough matchup. Anytime your center can face up from 18 feet and beat you off the dribble, it just creates, again, so many issues defensively in terms of providing help.
Baseline jump shot rims off. West with the rebound. Mazzulla. West Virginia looking for points now. Mazzulla, nobody picked him up, and he's fouled by Johnson. So confident with the ball in his hands. Then Mazzulla goes to the line for 2.
And take a look at what he does, how he initiates the contact at Juwan Johnson. He goes into him with the body, creates the contact. That puts the onus on the official to have to make the call. Smart player. Smart play, I should say, by the senior.
Joe Mazzulla getting his master's in coaching. Tell me he wouldn't be a great coach down the line. Tonight on a new CSI Miami. At this roller derby, the competition is so fierce, the real challenge is to stay alive. A new CSI Miami tonight, only CBS. Mazzulla missing 2 free throws. He's a 63% free throw shooter. 44-38, Purdue. Moore feeling it now. Inside, Johnson goes up high, jump hook. Short, cleared by Jones. And Mazzulla throws it out of bounds.
And Etwan Moore here, he's got it going from beyond the arc. He's had an exceptional season from the three-point line and struggled here of late, but in this second half, he's starting to warm up a little bit offensively.
So Truck Bryant returns to the game. Johnny West takes a seat.
Also checking in for Purdue, number 55.
Bryant with 8 points in the first half. As you look at Etwan Moore.
And remember in the first half, Coach Huggins went to this lineup with Mazzulla and Bryant in the backcourt, and they got into a much better flow offensively. They've been struggling here of late, and they have not been able to get any offensive rebounds.
Lewis Jackson with the turnover. Let's take a look at the stars.
And you see in the second half, 10 combined points from Moore and Johnson. They've taken control of the game, and thusly, that's why Purdue here now with a 2-possession lead.
Top of the key, Jones off the heel. Etwan Moore the other way. Jackson crossover dribble and a whistle. Hand-checking foul coming up against the Mountaineers. Good call by veteran official Jim Burke.
It was a great read by Jackson to attack once the defense emptied out from that strong side block. And let's keep an eye on Purdue offensively. Juwan Johnson, for the first time today, has come out of the game. So let's see how they run their offense.
So Flowers picks up his third team foul against West Virginia. Etwan Moore rimming off Truck Bryant. Bryant has to continue to look for his offense, Greg. He's playing the off-guard spot now with Missoula at the point. Baseline, and he'll go to the line.
And you called it. He's more effective at the shooting guard position. He's going to have to get going as West Virginia here is struggling. Basketball in the absence of Lance Stephenson.
But out of all those teams, it's so good to see what Steve Lavin is doing with St. John's and how he's bringing the Red Storm back, as you mentioned, blowing out number 11 Notre Dame today at the Garden. And he's got a top five recruiting class coming into Queens next year. So expect the Red Storm to really make a turn for the better with Steve Lavin as their head coach. And he's got guess who on the bench with him? No wonder. Gene Cady, the former Purdue head coach, as an assistant.
Yeah, great staff and a phenomenal job in terms of his recruiting. And, you know, he didn't have a bare cupboard with the group that he had coming back. DJ Kennedy, an exceptional talent, had a solid game today. 14 points for them in their win over Notre Dame.
Brilliant move by Lavin to hire Cady, who he worked for at Purdue in his first job as a graduate assistant. Now Jackson lobbing it inside and foul. Kalichla hand-checking Juwan Johnson.
Yeah, you know, but great job by Lewis Jackson. He took one extra dribble to create a passing angle. And, you know, that's something you don't often see in the college game. You have to create angles to be able to deliver the basketball for a scoring throw.
Juwan Johnson off balance somehow with great body control to bank it in. What can't this kid do?
Oh, he is an exceptional talent, and you like the fact that each year he's improved in some area of his game.
18 points for Juwan Johnson, who averages 19 and a half on the season. 6-point lead for the Boilers. Bryant, 8 to shoot. Tries to turn the corner. Off balance. Jones. And he puts it in. Kevin Jones, yeoman work, 10 points now. West Virginia cuts to 4. Jackson slicing. Lost it and we'll have the other.
And I tell you what, Daryl Bryant may have gotten away with a little contact on that drive. But here, you talked about the body control with the finish there. Beautiful play with his ability to catch in rhythm and finish up over the top.
And Johnson on pace to get his degree. He only has 2 classes this semester. Knocked away, picked up. But Flowers is there. Jones, mid-range, got it! Devin Jones coming alive. 2-point ball game in Manta. 46-44, Purdue. Jackson, offensive foul. Mountaineers siding with him now.
Moving their feet. Great defense there by Daryl Bryant.
Jackson picks up his second. As we take another look at the foul.
And that's just moving, as you mentioned, Gus, moving his feet and keeping the chest in front of that left shoulder of Lewis Jackson to create the charge.
Mountaineers with a chance to tie it up with the deuce and take the lead with the 3. Missoula feeds the post. Jones double. Skip pass. Thurman, great catch. Truck Bryant for the lead. And Jerome Johnson comes the other way. He'll fire a three. Not a good shot out of bounds.
Take a look, Juwan Johnson. He is such a talented player with the ability to score with his back to the basket and then step out on the perimeter to knock down the open jump shot as well. And boy, is he carrying this Boilermaker team here offensively. Can he do it down the stretch on the road is the question.
18 points, 5 rebounds for Juwan Johnson. Thurlman. 2-point ball game. Jones, they press him, and that's a 5-second violation.
5-second violation against the Mountaineers.
As you take a look at the two stars that we highlighted at the top of our broadcast.
And, you know, both are basically on course to get what they've done all season long in terms of their production. Johnson very efficient as well, shooting over 50%.
West Virginia, though, has turned it over 16 times. Purdue, 11. Etwan Moore. Drives to the basket, stops, turn around, Archer, pure.
And that ability to create offense individually when the defensive pressure rises, a big advantage in this game for Purdue.
Etwan Moore at 4 at halftime. He has 12 now. He averages 18 a game. Truck Bryant. Jones. Again. Kevin Jones. From Money Earning, Mount Vernon, New York.
He's feeling it.
And we've got a 2-point game, 48-46. Approaching the 8-minute mark. Each one. Curling inside. 15-foot fade. No!
Oh! Barlow! Young fella with the tip jam. Woo!
Or was that Juwan Johnson?
Official.
Barlow skying.
Pennsylvania.
7:55 to play in the second half. They're hooping hard in Morgantown. Welcome back, and let's take a look at the summary by half.
When you look at Purdue's shooting in the second half, I think that's directly attributable to the impact of Etwan Moore and what he's able to do. He gives them that great 1-2 combination, which is, I think, what makes Purdue an elite team.
How about Kevin Jones and how he's really stepped it up in the second half?
Yeah, Casey Mitchell, your leading scorer, really struggling to find any kind of a rhythm. So your best all-around player, Kevin Jones, who does a little bit of everything, attacking the offensive glass, knocking down the mid-range jump shot, and here off the dribble with a little pick and roll. You know, his confidence is starting to rise, and that's the reason why he's keeping West Virginia in this game. 9 rebounds as well. Solid performance by Kevin Jones.
As you take a look at Kevin Jones, close to a double-double. He needs 1 rebound. So here come the Mountaineers, trailing by 4. Missoula runs the point with Flowers, Thurlman, Casey Mitchell, and Kevin Jones. They're looking inside for Jones. Flowers a 3. Got it. Timely hoops, you know, for West Virginia.
That's a great point because, you know, this has been, in essence, an ugly game in terms of the flow. But again, the effort, the intensity, and then the timely shooting by Flowers.
Thurlman doing a good job on Juwan Johnson, making him work for everything. Johnson passed up the jumper. Thurlman's got great size at 6'7", and some beef on him as well. Johnson fires. That's off the heel. Contested by Thurlman. Rebound, Etwan Moore short. Batted around, Thurlman with the rebound. Cam Thurlman, he only averages 2 points a game, but he plays 17 minutes a game, and he's one of those guys that what he does doesn't show up in the box score.
The intangibles. His defense here this last stretch on Juwan Johnson, very important.
Mountaineers with a chance to take the lead right here. 10 to shoot. Missoula, high pick and roll. Jones pops out, rise and fire. Yeah! Timeout, Portland. Here we go, 6:26 to go. Second half, Mountaineers take the lead. They're up by a deuce. This is college basketball on CBS.
Well, West Virginia really struggling to find any flow offensively, but Kevin Jones has really set the tone here. Nice screen by Thurman. You talked about him, Gus. That's one of those intangibles. It's not a stat for a solid screen, but he sets it there to free Kevin Jones, and he's able to knock down the three.
As you take a look at Kevin Jones, who's just having a wonderful afternoon, 17 points, 9 rebounds, but somewhere in there, Cam Thurlman is the kind of player, as the huddle breaks, Cam Thurlman is the kind of player that you want on your basketball team because he has no problems accepting his role and doing the little thing.
And that's what allows your team to win. I often say, you know, he's not necessarily going to be the guy you win because of, but you win with because of the effort and the understanding of what it takes for your team to be successful.
Great point, partner. 6 ties, 11 lead changes. West Virginia is led by as many as 4. Purdue by as many as 6. Johnson beats Juwan Johnson. Thurlman right in his hip pocket. Each one more, purling again. Oh, and he gets the roll. Moore on the purl. And he knocks it down to tie it up at 52.
And that ability, when the pressure rises, the nice spin to create just enough space to get that jumper off.
Now Mitchell. Drives baseline, forced it. Yes! Plus the 5. And Mitchell looks at the crowd as if to say, it's about time I knocked down a jumper.
Well, the aggressiveness. We haven't seen this all game from Casey Mitchell. When you play great defense, folks, oftentimes you have to have the ability to create opportunities for yourself. And here, nice little freeze there with the fake of the reverse and then able to knock down the fade with the foul.
Well, Casey Mitchell, 5 points now, only 4 field goal attempts. Adds the free throw. And West Virginia takes a 3-point lead against number 8 Purdue. Been a tough couple of days for the Boilers. They lost to Tubby Smith's Minnesota Golden Gophers on Thursday. Blake Hoffarber lit them up. Hoffarber developing a step-back jump shot. And he's got lightning speed with it nowadays. And a foul coming up. This will go against the Mountaineers.
That's on Thurman, but that was a nice play. You're going to have a little up screen, weak side by Purdue, trying to get Juwan Johnson to that strong side post. Thurman recognized it, but just not able to anticipate it quickly enough.
So Thurman will come out of the game. He picks up his 4th. Kalichla back in. And Kalichla has to do a better job of taking care of the basketball. He'll turn it over. Each ball more. Down the lane, on the slice, the runner, no. Mazzola in heavy traffic, and he comes down with the rebound.
The little things, Gus. Your point guard getting back to the level of the basketball, coming up with a big-time defensive rebound. That's getting it done by committee by West Virginia. Great play by Joe Mazzola.
At the free throw line for the Mountaineers,
Joe Mazzula. One and one. And he missed the front end. But Kalichla there for the board. So West Virginia will restart it as we hit the 5-minute mark of the second half. Baseline, Jones again. And Moore has a rebound. Let's see if they go to their bread and butter. No. A steal. Great job by Flower. Stepping in the passing lane.
And if you're Purdue, you got to figure out a way to get the ball to Juwan Johnson. He's your best player. He has not touched it the last few possessions.
Thurlman did a great job denying him the ball. Now Kalichla trying to do the same thing as well. Flowers. Mountaineers.
Wow.
In Fuego. And they are rocking it out. In Morgantown. 4:16 to play, 58-52, Mountaineers. And the last basket, Flowers.
Yeah, just great recognition by Mazzulla. Goes for the penetration, forces the help, and Purdue unable to rotate out on the three-point shooter in time. And Flowers, the senior, knocks it down.
What a great atmosphere for college basketball, 14,000 strong, sellout crowd here at the West Virginia Coliseum, also known affectionately as the Mad Owls. We see why. Mountaineers on a mini 6-0 run to take their largest lead of the game. Lou Jackson, let's see if they can go to Juwan Johnson. Jackson curling. Beautiful.
When Johnson doesn't get the ball, but he makes the play. Beautiful back pick, then the pick and roll to get Jackson to the rim.
And LJ with 8 points for Purdue. 58-54. Jones. Kalichla. Another left-handed jump hook, and it's good. He's been terrific this afternoon.
And Gus, he goes right shoulder every time. If you're Juwan Johnson, you got to make the adjustment and make him go to his left shoulder.
Johnson wants it. Jackson runs a pick and roll again inside. Juwan Johnson and a whistle. That's a foul coming up on the floor against the Mountaineers. Back right after this. Gus Johnson, Greg Anthony with you as we take a look at the game reset. Possession arrow favoring West Virginia. 60-54, 3:19 to go.
The big possession coming out of the timeout for Purdue. Again, it's only a two-possession game. Lots of time left here. But offensively, Purdue has definitely been a little unsettled here the last few minutes as West Virginia's intensity has amped up.
So Johnson inbounds the ball on the baseline. Etwan Moore, Juwan Johnson, Moore down the lane. Lewis Jackson on the floor as well, along with Kelsey Barlow. They lob it inside, and a foul will go against, looks like, Kalichla.
West Virginia foul number 13, Dennis Kalichla. That's his fourth personal.
Good effort. This is
Johnson, and that will send Johnson to the line to shoot 1-1. 17 fouls against West Virginia. 14 foul against Kalichla. Juwan Johnson. A 78% free throw shooter on the season. And Johnson doing a nice job at the free throw line today. He's 4 of 5. As he gets both. 60-56. 20 points for Juwan Johnson.
And it was a concerted effort out of the timeout to get Johnson a touch on the low block.
West Virginia has done a great job knocking down shots. With time running up in the shot clock, they've gone to Jones and Flowers. Flowers running the baseline. 7 to shoot. Flowers throws it to Kalichla. Jackson tracks it down. Jackson to the basket, up and in. Superior quickness for Lewis Jackson, and we have a 2-point game. 2:23 to go. Mazzulla crosses over. They kick it. Flowers, one dribble, rises, and
it's Flowers.
What a big time performance. And again, West Virginia at times offensively really struggling to execute, but creating off the bounce.
Needs one more. Cut off by Flowers. Juwan Johnson spinning, turns. Oh, all America, folks. And he's rattled that one home.
I tell you what, he is so hard to defend out on the perimeter.
He has 22, 62-60. And Bob Huggins wants to talk it over. 1:43 to go in regulation. Mountaineers up by two. You take a look at the game reset, both teams shooting 1-1 with a couple of timeouts remaining, 1:43 to go. And West Virginia trying to hold on to this two-point lead.
It's interesting that right before the timeout, Cam Thurman was about to check in for defensive purposes, but the fact West Virginia has the ball offensively, they're going to leave Kalichla in the game because, again, they've really struggled here the last minute or so to get opportunities at the basket.
62-60. Now Missoula finds Flowers, sweeps it in front, drives, cut off. Mitchell off the back rim. Kalichla with a tough rebound.
And that's a perfect example. Kalichla gives you that offensively, what Thurman cannot. And he comes up with a big offensive rebound.
And another timeout called
West Virginia
by the Mountaineers. 1:16 to play. 23 on the shot clock for West Virginia. Here on CBS, as you take a look at the game reset. West Virginia with only one timeout now. Purdue still has two. Matt Painter wants the ball back, but there's 23 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
Yeah, we made that point about Kalichla. Again, remember, he's got six rebounds in this game, three offensive, and you're going to see a little bit of offense-defense substitution between him and Thurman down the stretch.
Missoula guarded by Lou Jackson. Flowers, Jones with Kalichla and Mitchell. Kalichla wants it. I don't know if his team wants him to have it in this situation. They give it to him. Missoula down the lane. 4-point game, under a minute to go. As they rise to their feet in Morgantown. Purdue, they gotta go to Johnson. He faces. Johnson drives on Kalichla, stops, turn around, and hits. He's got some Kevin Durant in his game. 64-62 and a five.
What a big-time play by Juwan Johnson. And you know what? Remember, they couldn't get Thurman in the game because they want to go offense-defense substitution. And Thurman has defended Juwan Johnson far better than Kalichla. Now they get the opportunity to get it in. But big free throws coming up here for Joe Missoula.
So Kalichla leaves. Great job by Dennis Kalichla. 8.6 rebounds on 4-of-8 shooting. Missoula, not a great foul shooter. 3-of-7 today. 1-1. 64-62. Shot clock off. And Matt Painter calls a timeout. Purdue has never lost to West Virginia. 64-62 right now. All right, once again, a look at the game reset. Each team with the timeout left. West Virginia with the arrow, and each team shooting 1-1. So for Matt Painter, I guess it's a simple decision on who you get the ball to in this situation.
Yeah, you're definitely, it's not a matter of who you're going to go to in terms of Juwan Johnson. It's how. I also think you're going to look for them to go earlier in the shot clock. This is not a situation because you're down two. You're not going to dribble it down. You're going to look to try to get an opportunity that's really quality early in the shot clock. Maybe you run them off a rough cut, possibly put them in a pick and roll, and you have the option also to ISO him in a 1-4 flat because of his ability to beat you off the dribble.
Juwan Johnson, 9 of 16 from the field, 24 points. He's posting Thurlman, Moore. He fires. Short. Missoula with the rebound. And West Virginia will shoot. And Etwan Moore probably should have given it to his horse.
You know you do. Etwan Moore is proven to be a guy that can take it, make big shots for you. But the big fella's got it going. You want to give him an opportunity down the stretch.
So Missoula this time will shoot two free throws. And it's been an adventure for him at the line. He's missed his last four.
Gus, I don't have to tell you how big this one is, because it will change your entire strategy if you're Matt Painter, if he's able to knock this down. That's, you know, needing three as opposed to a two. A lot more options to get two.
Smith comes into the game for Purdue. A terrific three-point shooter. And he got the second. Purdue's got to go for three. Or do they? Jackson off balance, no travel. Smith a three. Off the heel, Missoula with the rebound. 5 seconds, and Bryant calls a timeout. Boyner's got a great look at it.
He really did, and you know what? They went for the quick two. Again, figuring there's enough time to foul and get another opportunity. Jackson unable to convert the two. They get the offensive rebound, and a great look. Back rims it, and then Missoula comes up. Ryan Smith, he's a guy that's averaged 17 a game for you in conference play.
Bryant nails the first free throw, 66-62. And it's academic now for Bob Huggins and the Mountaineers. Truck Bryant, second, goes. And the Boilermakers call a timeout with 4 seconds to go. Up 67-62. West Virginia with the lead. 4 seconds remaining in regulation for Matt Painter and the Boilermakers.
Well, 5 points, obviously, not much you can do if you're Matt Painter. Well, Purdue, they really did compete in this game. Tough place to play on the road here in Morgantown.
West Virginia 0-5 all-time against the Purdue Boilermakers. And this is the first time since 1975 Purdue has traveled to Morgantown. Bird inbounds it on the baseline. He throws it into the front court. Juwan Johnson, turnaround jumper. Wow. He hits it with 1.8 to go. Missoula. And a foul. With 1.5 seconds remaining.
His third personal.
Flowers at the line, and he's a 74% free throw shooter.
Officials
and the officials
checking the clock, trying to make sure if the right amount of time is on the clock.
Right now it reads 1.5. The ball is inbounded with 4 seconds remaining. After the inbounds pass, 1.5 looks pretty accurate.
Yeah.
So the refs looking to make sure that the right amount of time was on the clock. And 67-64. What a game this one has been, Greg.
Wow. At the foul line for the Mountaineers, John Flowers.
So John Flowers at the line, perfect today. Three for three. And Flowers misses intentionally. Juwan Johnson, and that's it. West Virginia knocks off eighth-ranked Purdue. 68-64. And they're going crazy in Morgantown. So for Greg Anthony, this is Gus Johnson saying so long for Morgantown. The final score, the Mountaineers 68, the Boilers 64. Coming up, it's a special edition of the NFL Today, followed by the AFC Divisional Playoffs as the New York Jets clash with their arch rival, the New England Patriots. We'll send you to James Brown in New York with the road to the Final Four.